Okay, you guys, so as you can see, hi. I'm actually getting ready in this hotel bathroom. We are staying at the Hilton Garden Inn. I know we're in Hollywood, but I think that's what it's called, the Hilton Garden Inn. If you guys are familiar with doing makeup in bathrooms, the lighting is terrible, and it doesn't help that my foundation is like the wrong shade. But it's all good because I'm gonna have on a jacket. I might even wear a sweatshirt, so it's not that big of a deal. It's freezing out here. So I'm just finishing up trying to get ready so we can go have dinner. We're not going anywhere super fancy. I wanna go to the Hard Rock. So that is where I'm hoping we can go, the Hard Rock Cafe. They used to have one at City Walk, down by Universal City Walk, Hollywood, but I don't know. Last time we went, I didn't see it. It wasn't there. So it's supposed to be one close by. So I'm gonna see if Yahoo Maps is correct. But I just wanna finish getting ready. I decided to go with a green smoky eye. So I did use my Manny palette, the new, you know, facelift palette. Well, not really new, but it's new to me. And went in on my inner corner with one of my It's Belle shades, the Break the Rules palette. The palette is so bomb, you guys. So that's what I have on my eyes. And now I'm just trying to detangle my jewelry so I can finish getting it together. Okay, I think I figured it out. I just need to lay my edges a little bit better and then I'll be ready to go. So this little getaway really was just like, seriously, just a getaway locally, you know. Hollywood, I would say, is probably just about an hour or so, a little over an hour away from our, you know, house where we live. But, you know, sometimes it's still nice to just get away from the norm, you know. But this hotel, okay, for what they charging, honey, I'll probably give this hotel like 2.5 stars, honestly. And it's just for the amount of money they charge, they do not keep this hotel up like they should. It's like stuff that's like spackled together. Not even, it's a chair in there that I guess was broken or got a dent or a hole in it or something. And they patched it up with like white plaster and didn't even bother to like paint over it or anything. Mind you, the chair is brown and the plaster is white. Okay, so anyway, yeah, it's a bit of a mess up in here. And this place is not cheap either, because it's, you know, in the heart of Hollywood, so it is not cheap. But anyway, yeah, I would give this place like 2.5 stars. I would not stay here again, not at these prices, no ma'am. So anyway, but that's about it. That's gonna have to do it. I didn't bring a whole lot of stuff with me, y'all know, for doing a whole lot to myself, but this will have to do for the Hard Rock. Okay, so I'm gonna give you guys a little view of the room. Of course, it's not perfectly neat because we already been here one night, but I'm gonna let y'all see what it looks like just in case you're curious, and clean up my mess so we can get out of here. Anyways, we've already been here for one night, so, and it's super dark in here, but they have a little bit of decor. That's hubby over there chilling. It has the Hollywood sign on the wall here, so I guess to make you feel special or whatever, that you staying in Hollywood.
Hey, you might be real hard on this room.
Nah.
Never. How much are we paying for this room?
It could have been better for this price.
Exactly.
With the location, you can't beat it.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, no, I know. But anyway, so this is what the room looks like. And that's that. So we're gonna hit the road, go and get some dinner.
Finally. Let's go do it.
The lighting in here is atrocious. So y'all ain't gonna get no good lighting. Let me come down here. You ain't gonna get no good lighting from me. But anyway. So we're gonna go check out Hollywood, get something to eat. I'll try to do a little bit of vlogging, I guess, at the restaurant.
So you'll be fighting me back.
Janky. Even the door is janky. I will not be staying here again. Janky McJanky. Oh, we close to the elevator.
We got down the end. But that's my preference because the kind of rooms I like, they only on the ends.
Yeah. Well, you don't need that no more, though.
Well, I like the bigger rooms. That's where they're doing.
You want to tell the people why you used to like to have your rooms at the end of the hall?
For filming purposes. All them videos was made. Hotels, motels,
Holiday Inn. If your girl start acting up, hey. You ain't supposed to be finishing that. Let me find a song for me.
You gotta like one up.
To the left, to the left.
You won't be responding to that. Yeah.
We ain't got no sense, y'all. I'm telling you, if we had our own reality
that's
show.
What we should have our own
show. We should. Y'all would be like, girl.
Like, they love one another.
Are they really a couple? Really in love? On the elevator, getting ready to go down. I don't know. I don't think I'm really hard on hotels. I think I'm just, you know, no, I know what I like. Man, that was nice. It was real nice. It was like. It's not us.
Hey, excuse me. Is that them dirty?
Huh?
Are those dirty?
Yeah.
Yeah, can we just have a... Oh. No, no dirty. Please, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Sorry.
No dirty.
No, it's too small in here. We have dirty...
And you breathing in the... Yeah. The COVID sheets.
Yeah.
I feel you, boo. You don't want to know. No COVID sheets.
You know, tell me what's in them sheets.
Jesus, yeah. Just us?
So the food was down there.
Oh, the food was down there? Okay. Yeah. here backing up this big truck without looking. He's a camera user, y'all. Alright, I'm gonna go out here in this crowd with all the crazy craziness out here on Hollywood Boulevard, see what's happening. Ready, boo?
Yeah, I'm ready. Let me get my mask. Oh, okay.
Wait, you don't have one in there?
Yeah, I got.
Okay.
I got several.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
LA ain't playing.
I like that green one. Really good. Good pop, too.
Thank you.
I remember when you first did your face when you were in Maryland. I feel funny. I remember the girl. That's the girl that gave all the hugs to me and Bobby. She
let me that message. She said, girl, I don't know how you wear that. She said she love it, but she want to, you know, wear makeup like that.
You talking about out on the street?
Yeah.
Oh.
You remember we was in Maryland?
Yeah. We at the Roosevelt Hotel, y'all. Madame Tussauds.
Okay, what you doing here? What's up,
Mom? Get it?
Well,
so
he's taking
video.
A picture, yeah.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
We're going to block for you.
Thanks, Bobby.
No problem.
Tommy Lee Jones.
Oh, Mickey Mouse gone. What the heck?
Oh, Chinese man.
Uh-huh.
They're serving on lights.
I know. I always wondered. Wasn't it dark before?
Yeah.
So, this is called the Chinese...
It's the man's Chinese
Man's Chinese theater, right? All right. Thank you. Got all the stars on the Walk of Fame. Smell like fresh marijuana.
Vape.
Be shopping already.
not joking. I'm glad they asked for it. I knew an establishment like this,
uh-huh,
they're gonna follow it to the T.
Yeah. I mean, it's mandated out here, right?
In LA County.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what you're gonna eat, boo?
Yeah, do you wanna get a starter roll?
No. Let's see, what's good?
I don't know, they got wings, sliders, they got an onion ring tower. We better get that.
You want some onion rings?
Yeah, we get the onion ring tower.
Okay, we'll get some onion rings. Got my glasses, y'all. Y'all know I can't read this menu without my glasses. But tag is. Hubby be wearing my readers too. You know you gotta use them to read the comments. So I don't know what I'm gonna have, y'all. I'm sitting here looking at the menu, I'm not sure. I kinda want a burger. Twisted mac and cheese. Take a look at this menu and see what I'm gonna eat. I'll show y'all what I'll order.
Original legendary burger.
Why? What's on there?
Just a good steak burger, Applewood bacon, cheddar cheese, onion ring.
Oh, it's like one of them big burgers?
Yeah. I might have that.
Yeah, maybe I'll get that. Okay, thank you.
You was thinking that was for me, huh? I know he didn't get a shirt in trouble. I'll drink
that. I have not seen one. I actually don't really either. Right. Here and there, I'll have like a beer or two, but that's it, you know?
If I do have a drink, man, it'll be like a lady's drink. I like a little mix, something fruity,
yeah.
You know what I mean? And I drink half of it, she get the rest of it.
It's my Long Island, y'all.
Right.
Because I just... I don't know, I can't trust myself if I get drunk. You know, buzzing, I'm fine. Once I'm drunk, who knows what's going to happen with this guy?
Hey, you know what? I'd be scared to be all the way up like that.
Yeah, give you a couple minutes to go over the food?
I think we're ready.
I think we're ready.
Yeah. Okay. Baby, going to try my Long Island. See why I love him so much. That's good, huh?
I've had it before. It tastes a little bit. That's one of the better ones.
Yeah, that's a good one. I was like, that was fast.
I'm trying to make myself a girl around the world, bring my own music.
So you're just taking donations? I don't know what you got. Exactly. What you got?
We just taking donations.
What you got?
It's our music. We building up on the new technology and all that as well.
I appreciate the love too.
I love supporting my people.
Thank you, girl. Thank you.
You know. I don't know what that is. It's taking.
Uh-huh. On YouTube.
All over the place.
He's so tired right now.
You ready to lay out? I don't know if that's a drink or what. Okay, let me keep this camera rolling just in case.
They're gonna take that, mama.
Huh? They gonna... Don't say that. Do we walk down? We down there.
P1.
Oh, it's the best for you. Here.
Woo, okay. Oh, good. I got some grip on these boots.
Are we on P1?
Yeah, because we came up, remember? Yeah. An eventful night. What was it?
On the floor. Under your feet.
That's
the
first ride. What'd you say? Where was it?
On the floor. Next to the French fry that you didn't drop.
Whatever. I did not put your hat down there. I don't know how your hat got down there, but it wasn't for me. Okay. Whew, child. We done been out with the exotics tonight, y'all. Everybody and mama was out. Pennywise. Homeboy from that Vegas movie. We got the brothers out selling CDs. Just everybody was out tonight.
The killer party. It's getting hard because like a lot of cars don't have CDs. Like I couldn't play that in here.
Right. I didn't even think about that. You know, it's like, what you playing that on? I didn't even think about that. Hold on, let me put my seatbelt on and whatnot. I said, you got one of the CDs, right? I don't know how we gonna play it. I was just thinking, y'all, we was talking about, like, how we gonna play it? We don't even have no CD player. Like.
I'm still sending them to
me. Yeah, I'm just saying, but we don't even have no way of playing it. My computer don't take a CD. The car don't take a CD. So we just... They gonna have to start hustling with some, what do you call them? The USB sticks. Hustling the USB sticks, you know? But it's pretty wild out here tonight. Shoot, I only been to Hollywood Boulevard once. Hubby brought me out here a long time ago. And it was right after Michael Jackson had passed. But it's shoot.
the Las Vegas trip out this mug. I was pretty surprised. It's pretty cool though.
There's not that many people.
You said it's not that many people? Shoot, it seemed busy to me. Not like it usually is. Oh shoot, it was enough. If it was any more for me, I'd be. Like, yeah, you could. That would be a personal choice of yours. I mean, I always support my people, you know? But I don't know if we really live in an era of people just buying CDs and stuff anymore. Because, like I said, we don't even have no way to play it. I think nowadays, don't people put their music, like, up on Apple and, you know, what is it, SoundCloud and stuff like that? No, they just upload their music and people download it, you know, for $1, $5, $10, whatever. Or the chicken spot. So, yeah.
You gotta get people to go there.
Right, and I think, so that's probably the new way to hustle your music that way, because... That was fun. Very fun. So, all right, I guess we headed back to the hotel.
I passed our street. I just came down here just a little.
Oh, you just kind of cruising? So, it's all right. We can cruise and see what's happening. Look at all the tattoo joints and the stripper clothes joints, taco trucks. Taco trucks over here, y'all. Well, food trucks. Food truck lane or something. Mm-hmm. I always wanted to go to one of those, you know, where they have all the food trucks in the alley or something like that.
And they got one in San Bernardino.
Oh, do they?
Mm-hmm.
We got to check it out.
My buddy be there.
Is it every weekend?
Yeah, I think it's getting ready to stop too. This Saturday might have been the last.
Why? Because of the weather?
Because of the weather. Then they stop. But it's a place like Food Truck Row.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I want to go to one of those, just try out some different food truck places. See what's happening. Some of them be having some interesting food that I want to check out. Alright y'all, I guess we're gonna cruise a little bit. I'm gonna need you to clean your windshield.
I want my windshield. I want your phone.
Well, down here, but not up here. It's not your windshield. That's my dirty phone, my dirty camera. That's what you're trying to say. It's my dirty camera. I'm talking mess.
You know what? I've accepted that my life is just full of having a camera in my face. It doesn't even bother me.
I'm just saying. You should be used to it by now.
Well, what's good, everybody? And welcome back to my channel. Smoking and grilling, and now we driving with Mitch and
Mitch. You trying to irritate me.
Check it out. We out here on Hollywood and Vine. Hey, now I'm from here. I'm the only one that can really say this, but check this out. This is called Hollywood. This is what we call it.
Really? That's it?
Hold on.
What's
happening
over there?
Hamilton. That's culture.
Where the club's at? Mayweather Boxing.
That's one in Haven City Market.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. All the way down the end by the mailbox.
Oh, one of them outside?
It's inside and outside.
Hmm.
So as y'all can see, I had a pretty eventful night here in Hollywood, or Hollyweird as they say. So I'm about to wash my face so I can take a shower, go to bed, all that good stuff. But like I had said in my last vlog, when I pack to travel, it's a lot of stuff I just keep in my toiletry bag, and my skincare is one of those things until I finish it up. So in my toiletry bag, I have the Ole Henriksen little skincare set. It was one of their gift sets, I think, from like a year or two ago that I got. So it comes with this Find Your Balance oil control cleanser. So it's a nice little size tube to travel with. You also get a toner. So it's a Balancing Force oil control toner. So I have that. And then I also have this oil control hydrator. So I'm gonna go ahead. First thing I'm gonna do though is try and take off the bulk of this makeup with wipes. I know they're not the most environmentally friendly, but you know, when I travel, I do like to just throw some wipes in my bag just to make my life a little bit easier, as opposed to just getting makeup everywhere. So we're gonna go ahead and wipe off this crazy off-tone foundation. I don't know if maybe my skin tone is just really different right now. You know, from not being outside as much and stuff like that, because I don't remember my NYX foundation being so different from my skin tone and being so off, you know. So, but you know, you never know. You never know. It could have been really off all along and I just didn't realize it. But in these bathroom lights that we got here, honey, that foundation was not right. So thank goodness I had powder and stuff that was a good, you know, match for me that helped to kind of balance everything out. So right now I'm just kind of focusing on my base. It's so weird, I'm like wiping around my brows like they're gonna come off, but watch this, y'all. They're still there. I love it, I love it, I love it, child. I'm like, why didn't I do this sooner, okay? All I do now is just clean them up with concealer, and honey, I got brows, okay? So I feel like she did a really good job. And when I go for my touch up in January, I feel like she's only gonna have to, you know, just do little touch ups here and there, cause she did a really, really good job. For her first go round with my face and everything, she did a really good job. So, you know what? One trick that I do with my eye makeup, if I'm like on the road or in a hotel out of town or something and I didn't bring a makeup remover balm, is I would take like a moisturizer or some lotion or something like that. And you know, you gotta be careful though, cause you don't wanna get it in your eyes. But I will use that to loosen up my makeup. So I'm gonna get some lotion right quick. And you know, and typically in the hotel, they're gonna have a little lotion or whatever that you can use. And nowadays, sometimes the lotions that they put in the hotel, yeah, it's just a plain white lotion, are like unscented, hypoallergenic and stuff like that, because they know some people are allergic. So I'm going to use a little bit of lotion just to kind of, I already took my lashes off, just to kind of loosen up my eye makeup, because one thing I do forget to bring with me sometimes is makeup removing balm, you know. So I need to remember to throw some in my travel bag. So That's one thing that I just keep in my travel bag along with all of my other staples, is a makeup removing balm. You know, because the eye makeup sometimes can get a little tricky, especially with the eye looks I do, okay? So, you see it just loosened everything up. So now I'm just going to take my wipe and wipe it off before I actually wash my face. So, see how easy that is? Just loosen it up. And it might not loosen up all of like the mascara and stuff because, and I'm kind of aggressive on my eyes, you know. You probably shouldn't be so aggressive on your eyes, but because I have worn contacts for like the last, I don't know, 25 years or so. Well, not that long because I'm not 50. But I have been wearing them since I was about 25, I think. So, yeah, I've been wearing them for a good 23 years. You know, and you just kind of get used to, like, sticking your fingers in your eyeballs and stuff to put contacts on, take them out and stuff. So, I'm a little more aggressive with my eyes than you probably should be. So now I'm gonna go in with this Ole Henriksen cleanser, you know, and wash my face. This cleanser, it has kind of like a minty or eucalyptus type smell to it. I don't know what it is. It smells therapeutic, if you know what I mean. But yeah, I'm just gonna go in and make sure everything is nice and clean. So good when you take your makeup off just to let your skin breathe. Oh, it feels good. Okay, let me rinse this off. Okay, face is nice and clean, feels amazing, but I need to see if I have some little cotton pads for my toner. I guess I ran out of the little cotton pads that I usually keep in my travel bag. So I'm going to, and I have a whole bunch of them at home, okay? So I'm going to improvise. I'm just going to use a little tissue just so I can put a little toner on my skin to try or to help balance it out after, you know, the night I've had. So I'm just going to just gently tone a little bit. I don't want to wipe because I don't want to get a whole bunch of little pieces of tissue all over my face. But I do want to hit my skin with some of this toner, okay? That feels good. Okay, and then lastly, we're going to go in with our oil control hydrator. System is like, it feels very therapeutic. You know those like essential oils and stuff that you smell when you go to get a nice massage, or you know, you go and have different skincare things done, and the office just has that nice kind of therapeutic scent to it. That's what all of this stuff smells like. It smells very therapeutic and it feels amazing. It has a cooling effect, like it has peppermint or something in it. I don't know. But it feels good.